Jesus. so much. Love these guys. Now you see why they've become a part of our story and such an important part of our lives. And we're glad for them to be able to be in town and get to spend a little bit of time with them. So, you know, their story became a part of our story, mine and Joy's story. And that story led us to healing. Now, that's our purpose. Is the demoniac had his story. You have your story, I have my story. Our purpose is to share that with other people, because when your story becomes a part of their story, when your story becomes a part of their story, their spiritual journey, when you are instrumental in somebody either coming to know Christ for the first time or get to a place where they grow in an area of their lives, or they make a faith commitment of some kind, then your story becomes a part of their story. And go back one slide, guys. So you take your story, and you combine it with my story, and you combine it with their story of all the people around us that have a story of Christ, then that is what Christ's story is. His story is about all of our stories being put together, because he's not physically walking here anymore. He's not physically here to deliver the demoniacs. Hey, that's us. That's his church. That's my life. That's their lives as missionaries. That's your life where you walk every day, where you go to school, where you work, the people you encounter, the people at the grocery store, the people at your pharmacy, the doctor's offices, the different places you find yourself in a day. You are to be sharing your story. Because you never know when your story is going to become a part of somebody else's faith story that impacts their lives, because that is his story. His story is all of us coming together. And then our story, as Vine, is church. Church, our purpose of church, we've talked about so many times, part of that is it's where you bring your story, I bring my story. God intertwines those stories together to where we get equipped and impassioned and encouraged and educated on how do we get out there to share his story to those that are like that demoniac, that are in bondage, that are afraid, that are overwhelmed, that are hopeless, that are helpless, that are in need of deliverance. So that's why we're here today. I don't know where you came from today. I don't know if you are here as visitor, where you are in your spiritual journey, a lot of you. But I encourage you to take the time today to examine, where are you in this journey with Christ? Well, where is your story? Are you at a place where you know for certain you've given your life to Christ? You know, you don't want to be like that demoniac demon who knew about Jesus, knew the power of Jesus, knew what was to come, but didn't have a relationship with God. Do you have that relationship? You know, you don't have to, you know, like Sarah Lee talks about being saved, coming to know Christ through the work of a missionary there in the Philippines. Man, does that not encourage you to be a part of missions? You know? See how that missionary, their story became a part of her story became a part of our story, and then our story became a part of your story? So amazing. So amazing how God works. But, you know, a lot of folks end up just staying in the tombs. You stay there among the dead. You stay there in bondage, in chains, overwhelmed, confused, frustrated, addicted, and they're waiting for us to come and share our story with them. And this morning, I encourage you to take this time. We're going to take a few minutes. We're going to sing a song, and we're going to have a time where you can just allow the thought, the meditation on this passage of what Jesus said. What did Jesus say to do? Hey, go share your story. Go share your story. But you may be here this morning, you think, you know, I don't really have a faith story. I don't have a story of really being like that demoniac where I know God delivered me. I don't really have that. I'm not at that place yet. Well, hey, today we can help you come to that place where you can know for certain that you have a relationship to God. I mean, today may be the first chapter of your faith story of really committing your life to Christ. We'd love to talk with you about that, share with you about that. Some of you, you have that beginning chapter. You know for certain you've come to that place in your life where You know God. You remember that day where he took you from that miry clay and he pulled you out of there and he set you on that solid rock. And you know he delivered you. You know he began a process of setting you free. But you've kind of wandered away from it, you know. You've allowed the things of the world, distractions, friends, bad choices, relationships, things of the world to kind of draw you away. And today can be the day. Hey, we love chapters of returning. Those come home chapters. Those chapters in your people's story where they know God, but they walk far away, and then they come back to an intimate relationship. They come and they resubmit, they recommit their lives to Christ. Hey, that may be where you are today. You can come and add that chapter to your story. But all of us are somewhere on a journey. And I don't want us to take and see this story about the demoniac, hear about these missionaries that are giving their lives serving in this foreign country to meet the needs of people, and then us just leave and it not have any impact on our desire or where we are in our story. So we're going to, Steve's going to come up in a minute when I pray. They're going to sing a song. It's just going to be a time for you to meditate on those thoughts. Don't check out yet. And take a time and just say, God, what would you have me to do today? God, what kind of commitment do I need to make today? And if you need to come down here, we make this little step. These are just regular old steps, but on Sunday mornings during this time, we set this as a place where if you want to come pray, you can come down here and just pray. Meet with God. If you want to pray with somebody, you can grab Joy be down here. Dwayne and Jennifer will be down here. Alan Donis. If you want to grab somebody, pray with them. Luke's over there. They'll pray with you. Or if you're just right where you are, you can pray. See God. But don't let this chance miss you. We have this time to make a fresh commitment. Let me pray. Lord, thank you so much for Les and Sarah Lee. And thank you for their story. Thank you for how it impacted my story. Thank you for getting us to this place in our lives. But God, we come to you, Lord, just seeing this demoniac's story. Thinking about just how oppressed he was. How destroyed he was. How overwhelmed he was. And then God, we look and see how you delivered him, and then how you say, go share the depth of the mercy that he received. God, we come this morning asking you to be with this time of decision. I pray, God, that people here will be obedient to you. God, I pray that this time will be a sweet time of people being restored to where you want them to be, people making decisions to be baptized or join the church or whatever decisions we need to make. I pray we'll make it during this time of decision. We'll give you the praise. You're a good God. Thank you that you love us. Thank you that you care for us. Thank you that you are continuing, as Les said, to add pages to our story. Thank you that you hadn't gave up on us. Thank you that you hadn't just turned your back and you haven't just given up and thrown your hands up in frustration, even after repeatedly we let you down. You're just continuing to add to the story, your story. And we praise you for it. We give you the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Stand where you are. Spend the time together with God. Lay down.